7 and I'm back with another one of my makeovers for my townies in my main save. This time it is actually the household that Indra lives in, so it's basically they're three friends that live together in a pretty big house that Mona was able to obtain from relatives. But first I am doing Kira. I figured since, you know, for the most part, most people, if you watch my Eevee series, you probably know who Indra is, and he has more of a role compared to the other two, and they're not seen as much, that I would focus on those two first before I get to Indra. But this is Kira, which is actually Indra's friend that he's had the longest out of the two, and she's also the one that has a crush on him, but he does not feel the same way back, which is why there's been, like, the whole issue throughout the series of why Vaporeon and Indra even split up in the first place. It's because of her. But I decided to give them a makeover because, really thinking about it, they're one of the family, like, groups that I haven't really went in and edited their outfits too much. Plus the fact that I'm having to go in and add hot and cold outfits to everyone also just added the fact that I was like, I just need to go and do makeovers for almost all of my families at this point. So I definitely won't be recording all of them, but some of them I probably will. But anyway, I say too often. Really sorry about that, but that's just like the first instinct to try to keep my mouth moving while processing what to say next. So yeah, anyway, sorry about that. And there I go again. That was actually instead of an so it's slightly different, but still I say both of them way too much. But with Kira, I was she does wear mostly white in her other outfit, and I do keep her other outfit, but I do change her hair. I let her hair down longer because she had had them in buns so long that you would imagine maybe they had been, her hair had been growing, but you just didn't realize it. But she dyed the ends purple, is still kept some of the more peachy rose gold tone towards the top, but the ends are now purple. But I decided I was going to try to put a little bit more black because she wears a lot of white in her other outfit. So I added a little bit more black because I thought it sort of suits her. She is a vampire. Not that that means that she has to wear black, but I'm just saying usually it suits them pretty well. But I do give, in this video, I do give the edit their cold and hot outfits. Now for the vampires, the hot outfit probably won't matter as much as the cold outfit because they can't go outside unless they have sun resistance. So if they have sun resistance, yeah, it would matter. I do give her like a floppy hat for her hot wear because I would imagine she'd be like trying to shield herself from the sun as much as possible. But if they do add the whole thing where vampires can actually walk out outside with the umbrellas over top of them, then you know her hot outfit would be more used more often because she would have the umbrella as protection. I really hope that is implemented in a future update because I think that would be so cool. And it'd also be so nice to be able to invite any of my vampires over at any time. Just let them use the umbrella until they at least get to the house. They should survive long enough then. Like, I want to be able to invite them over at all times. A lot of my families or like friend groups, if they're related or friends with a vampire, half of the time they have to wait until like 7, 8 o'clock, depending on where you live, to invite the people over so that it's safe enough for them to come outside. So it's like a little bit of a But so there's that little thing that I'm really, really looking forward to. But next would be Mona. I sort of keep Mona, I know I'm currently still working on Kira, but just to talk about Mona because she's about to come up. She is definitely the more professional and businessy one out of the three, so I do try to keep her looking more professional, more, like, businessy. I did realize that her formal outfit was missing. I don't know if I checked to make sure that any of her other outfits was missing, but her formal outfit was missing. I do give her longer hair as well, and she has basically made the minty aqua color just a little bit darker, a little bit deeper, just to give a little bit of a change, but she still wants to stay sort of similar in the color that she had, but she just made it a little bit darker. And again, I keep her original outfit as well, but I set it back to outfit number 2. So she still has that outfit and will appear in that outfit, but she has a new outfit now too. And I've been wanting an excuse to use this shirt, and I thought it was like businessy, but also very sort of fashion forward type sort of style shirt, and I go away from it, but I do eventually come back for it because I've been wanting to give it to someone, and I thought it was suiting her personality very well, so I do give her that shirt and I think a skirt and stuff. Now with them, it was really easy to sort of start giving them a makeover, and with most of my females, I have an easy time giving them a makeover, and I actually love giving them a makeover. I'm like, ooh, what new hair can I put on them this time? What new clothes to put on them this time? I'm almost completely opposite with my guys. Not so much because I don't have as many options as the females. I'm pretty sure I'd still have the same issue if I had the same amount of options or even more options. It's just something about my male Sims. They start to have a certain look about them, and I sort of like that look, so I have a really hard time altering away from that look, I guess. Because, like, when I got to Indra, and I did change his hair, though. I actually did change his hair. It took a lot, but I changed it. But I was going through the hairs, and I was like, I don't like it. I don't like it. I don't like it. It doesn't look like Indra. I don't like it. But I did finally change it. I settled on one hair that I still thought looked somewhat like he would wear it and looked nice on him. So I gave him that, and maybe over time, it will grow on me. Hopefully I won't end up editing him later on to just give him the same old hair because I can't absolutely stand the new hair. With Riker, I didn't have so much of that problem, but there's a lot of them that I do. Like Jolteon and Umbreon, they're two big examples that I'm like, I don't want to change them. The outfits are not so bad. It's more the hairstyle. Something about the hairstyle on guys, on my male Sims, just gives them that certain look and gives them like, yep, that's that person. And I have a hard time swaying away from that hairstyle. But I did. I tried. I did it. And, you know, he's got a new hairstyle, so it's all good. Hopefully, you know, I don't think it looks bad. So hopefully I won't get the urge to ever try to change it. We'll just see. But let me know how you think his hair turned out, because that was my biggest thing, was like I had the hardest time changing his hair. That's the hair I decide to stick with. And I do think it looks good. It does look good. I do like it. But at the same time, there's a part of me that's still like, I shouldn't see both of Indra's eyes. It's like, I shouldn't. But, you know, maybe he's trying to be, look, I don't know. Yeah. I still probably should try to change Umbreon's, because he's had the same hair since I've created him, I'm pretty sure. But again, it's my whole thing, like, I have a hard time changing it. I think Indra and Umbreon actually had the same hairstyle, to be fully honest with you. Now they don't, so I mean, I guess I can at least look at it that way. But still, I didn't want to do it. But I do like still how he overall his look turned out. He still has his old look, which I think I'm still more fond of his old look in general. That just maybe also still be my mindset. When it comes to my male Sims, maybe I get so stuck on the way they look compared to the females. I don't know. I don't really know how my brain is working when it comes to this whole scenario, but hey. We'll just have to roll with it. I did at least change him, so can't say that I didn't change him. I gave it a try. But, you know, I hope y'all like how all three of them turned out and how their new looks are. Let me know how you thought about all three of them, particularly Indra, because, you know, that's just part of my brain is still almost wanting to go back to his old hairstyle for whatever reason. But anyway, let me know what you thought of them. I will have all of my Sims 4 playlists down in the description below, so if you want to see some of my previous makeovers, they'll be in the cast playlist, so that you can go find them there. I might make a whole new playlist just for my makeovers, but I'll still add them to the cast, because with cast, I add all of my Create a Sim sort of stuff in it for the most part, but some of them, if I do like a mini-series based off of it, I might make a new playlist. So I might make a playlist for this stuff as well, so you might want to keep an eye out for that as well, so if you just want to see just the makeovers. But Don't forget to share the video if you enjoyed it so that others also can enjoy it as well. And also hit that little notification bell so you'll know when the next video comes out. If you have any other townies who you think you want to see a makeover done actually on camera, let me know down in the description? Down in the comments below. And I'll definitely look into doing their makeover on camera. And all of my social media will also be down in the description below, so if you want to go follow me on those if you're not already, so you can be more updated on other things and just sort of have a feel of what's going on. But anyway, thank you so, so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. And bye-bye!